When you first look at it, it's just these 16th notes and about 3 million of them. You think, okay, so what the hell are we doing? And I think you're doing a really nice job. You're shaping it, you're doing some good stuff. But what sort of informs you in terms of how you shape it? What do you think about it? Apart from what your wonderful teacher tells you to do, of course you do exactly.
Of course. Probably the modulations.
Yeah. So you're thinking harmonies and where, yeah. So what a lot of things you did I really like. I like the sort of forthright way of playing. It's like, you know, they say, great, this is it, this is great. Sometimes I wonder if you could have a little bit more subtlety in there, perhaps. So, I mean, you're actually sort of in a way, you're not doing the opposite to what we heard with the Hindemith, but you know, you're all making a huge sound, you're filling this space really, really well. So I think you can just come down sometimes, you know. But when we're playing Bach, every prelude, I mean, there are such amazing pieces, these things, and they're all so different. And this one, of course, I think he uses a trick at the beginning, like Haydn's does in the string quartets. He sometimes starts with three big chords. It's like waking the audience up, saying, well, stop talking, then we're starting. So it's like, in a way, it's da-da-da, you know, you're getting everyone to shut up, to listen. And the mood actually starts here. We start there, okay. So I like a little contrast between this very beginning and then what you do here. So it's like a different animal, okay. So let's just go from the beginning. Small for the pitch of plays that composed by Cello. Okay, now I'm built like an orangutan. I've got long arms. this spot sort of waiting in anticipation is a great performance. People want to go, dirt, like, I want to fill your in breath. If you're going to speak this or sing it, what would you do first?
For you.
Exactly, in or out?
In.
Yeah, go, like that. But you sort of went, okay, so imagine, make yourself bigger and do that. So what's the lowest note in this bar?
G. C. A. No, that's a G, sorry.
That's a G, yeah. Sorry, I've got my glasses over there. Everything's blurred here, so yeah. Okay. So if you think, so in a sense, we have a combination here of a sort of melodic structure and a harmonic structure. Okay. Now a lot of this we might think of harmony. Okay? So if we go in a way, it falls on the second beat. It's like a phrase. Perhaps not quite so much here, but definitely on this G here. Okay, that's showing you the harmonic structure. So it's in a way, it's showing the bass line. But then what happens in this bar? The emphasis is on the downbeat, not the second beat. So that, by combining a sort of harmonic structure with melodic structure, we give a rhythmic structure. That's cool, okay? So I'm not saying you have to exaggerate, but let's play it and just exaggerate this a little bit, okay? Not this one quite so much. Exaggerate that one, but then really, we go da 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 da, and then after that, da 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 da. It's like an afterthought, okay? Because that's where you're right. And then I'll compare that with this scale here, which is very different. But let's just go from this C. So let's just have a little look ahead, because when we get to, did I mean this one? Yes. So could you play from here? Structured brilliantly. But So if the more you're aware of finding those shapes, because we look at this, and it's just a series of 16ths, we go, what? It's a tricky, isn't it? Somehow we have to put it together and construct it. So we have to understand it harmonically and melodically. So let's move to my favourite bit, which is this bit here. So let's go from here. And sorry, just so think.
That's okay.
Think about the harmony. I want to feel the bass line, okay? And another thought I have from Hamilton Bach as well. The ear tends naturally to be drawn towards melody. We just hear, because the melody tends to be the upper line. Not always, it tends to be. We hear the melody. This viola plays, what do we normally do with a harmony? And I think in these, something we can do even more uniquely than cellos perhaps, is bring out a harmony. That's an inner harmony, because melody is not melody without harmony. It informs the melody. So if we really work at it, if I want you to play this, let me feel, where's the bass line, where's the harmony stretch, where's the tension there, okay? So can we just go from there?
Thank you.
wants one, really make it like a writing somewhere. So just go from a pass a little bit higher up the bow.
Yes.
The sound is nice, but it's a bit too direct. Great start, that's good.